What's up? My name is Rocky G. I'm a musician, filmmaker, and educator. So I grew up in a very musical family. My father was a musician, my mother sang. I actually grew up in the whole DC metropolitan area and was surrounded by a lot of musicians. And in the fourth grade, I finally picked up a saxophone. With the saxophone came a plethora of other instruments. I just stuck with this ever since fourth grade, and it's honestly been my calling. I got into rapping when I was in high school. I started writing more when I graduated. So I like to draw a lot of influence from music that came before me, as does everyone, you know? As far as like actual songwriting goes, I super look up to the Beatles. As far as rapping goes, I say my biggest influence is Mos Def and Talib Kweli from Black Star. I could listen to them all day. I will also say my influence in saxophone is Cannonball. Dope player, you know, from his runs to his range. Those are all very different types of musicians and styles, so I try to incorporate all that together through a Filipino-American lens. I used to write very poetic and nonsensical music back in the day when I was like 18, 19. As I've gotten older, I'm 23 now, my music has become more focused and more message-based, or at least storytelling-wise. Besides the technique from the flow, I want you to know what I'm saying, you know? I think my struggles, I still write about it to this day. I still write music about it. If I keep my struggles close to my heart, I'll never forget where I came from, and I think that's very important. Back in 2013, my dad passed away back home in DC, and it was kind of hard for me, you know, because I was just out here living in the Tenderloin with my mom, and I didn't really know anyone. Just having to cope with that by myself, all I had was music, you know? All I had was to write, all I had was my sax, whether it was playing in the corners of downtown SF or at Union Square, making a little bit of money because I was broke, you know, or just writing out my feelings, and I was just kept on writing my music, kept on writing. And it was sad, man. It was like sad music, and it was just like, I had to get that off my chest, but it was also very healing, you know? I think getting myself immersed in the community, whether it was through skating, through music, through graffiti, through filming, I was blessed to meet a bunch of cool people out here that showed me the ropes. After I found the studio, it was all about finding a producer to work with, so I found my best friend, my brother who lives in LA now, Nug Life, and I made my first album with him back in 2016 called The Other Side. At that time, when I released that album, I was currently at SF State, and I was taking some ethics studies classes, and I would say from there on is when my music has really changed.
Here in the United States, you know, I experienced discrimination, and the message that I received was that for me to be accepted in this particular society was to become as American as possible.
I'm writing more about my history, and when I say my history, I mean my people's history. Learning more about Filipino-American history and the importance of the people that came before us, I really wanted to incorporate that into my music as well. I think one of the biggest influences for me as of right now too is just reading books. Reading Brown Skin, White Minds, reading America's in the Heart, Little Manila's in the Heart. It had a major impact on where I want my music to go. Because you don't have to be an educator just in the classroom. You could be an educator through your music, through public speaking, through relationships, and I definitely want to explore those concepts. You know, I've been performing a lot, man, whether it was in jazz band, orchestra, or talent shows. I've just been performing a lot. I've been exposed to it, but that doesn't mean I don't get nervous. You know, that nervousness turns into energy that I just let it out on stage. And I know when the crowd is really feeling it because I'm looking out, but most of the time I got my eyes closed. I really put my heart and soul into my music. Talking about my struggles earlier, I put that into my lyrics, I put that into my melodies, and I just want to let it all out. You know, it's a form of healing, it's a form of release. Not only being able to write this music, but being able to perform it is a blessing. And having people listen to me is also a blessing. You know, I'm very appreciative of people's time. I know the space we're in when in a performance is very intimate, you know? I'm letting out my heart. I'm telling my life story through my music. In order to expand your personality and your mind and your spirit, I definitely believe you need to foster relationships in as many people as you can, whether it's through community work or just even just chilling out and talking to someone, getting to know them. A phrase I like to go by is pray to understand rather than be understood. And I think that definitely benefits towards your music or art or craft, you know? Your craft will always be changing, and pay attention to what other people create, for sure. Not just because like, oh, I want to make sure I'm not doing the same thing as other people, but you see individuals such as Ruby Ibarra, Alison Tintiango Kubalas, how they've used their art and their craft and their passion to open up the lane for artists as me and other people as well. You really see the possibilities and the spectrum of what you can do.